to send her. Damn. She keeps on bad.
Five, four, three, two, one. Hey guys, Justin Wayne here. And right now I'm with Cameron Dash, one of my old clients who is now, you know, definitely improving. And the one thing that I wanted to talk about with you is this thing we're just talking about ideal game. You know what I mean? Like, what happened when you said you talked to this girl and she actually said what? She noticed that, you know.
Yeah, it's a funny situation. You know, I was I went in direct and I started talking to her, but my mindset was like, you know, let me try to be smooth and like player like. You know, it's like, you know, this stereotypical. You know, I was just trying to be, you know, more smooth, like, act, you know, trying to make it too perfect in a way.
Yeah.
But then it backfires, you know. It's funny because she said she turned and looked at me and said, "Like, do you do this a lot?" And I'm like, "What do you mean?" You know, she catch me off guard. You know, she was like, "You just seem like the, like, you know what you're doing. Like, you just like, you seem like the kind of guy that you talk to people a lot." And I was like, "Yeah, you know, I'm a social guy, I guess. You know, I talk to people." And she was like, "No. You have this vibe. Like, you do this a lot. You know." I guess to her, I was coming off too smooth. You know, it wasn't natural. It was off, and she could sense that. Anyone could sense it. You know, if you're talking to a guy that just seems too, like, everything just too smooth, too perfect, it just, you can tell, like, something's off. Like, what are you saying? What are you doing?
It doesn't connect. And that's one huge flaw I see a lot of people having. A lot of people are assuming that, you know, the ideal way a guy meets a woman, approaches a woman in a stranger approach setting, they think the ideal way is to come across like you came from a movie and you have to talk so slow.
Yeah.
It looks so romantic. Be smooth talking. And you know what? This is the funny thing. This is all developed by Hollywood, by the way.
Exactly.
You know, like the whole Hollywood mentality of like what a smooth guy is supposed to be. Now this is a sad thing though. The Hollywood thing doesn't work in real life. So in Hollywood, let's look for example at a movie like Hitch or James Bond, right? Now, you know, they did a good job in general in terms of, you know, having general characteristics. But if you actually, you know, if you actually think really, really carefully, like, you know, when you're really that smooth, I remember like from my experiences also. You know, before I started getting a lot of results, at one point I got really smooth too, and I still got the same response you got at times. And you know, I get nothing but flaky numbers, meaning numbers that go nowhere. And one of the main reasons why was because, you know, they can feel. I mean, it doesn't feel legitimate. And if it's just so smooth, you cannot connect with someone. It's almost like, you know, I don't know if any kind of salesperson has came to you where they're very smooth, and yes, their delivery is good, but it just still doesn't work on you because you know it's not real. So
it's not natural.
It's not natural. Yeah. I mean, so people, for example, I had this video out. It was called a Justin Wayne Instant Date Video Analysis or something like that. And on the video, it shows me a little bit shaky in certain aspects, and some people were saying, "Oh well, this is, you know, this thing, he doesn't look smooth as I thought he was supposed to look smooth, whatever." And you know, it's not, you know, it's what they're looking for is like a Hollywood version of how it's supposed to be. And yeah, I mean, I consider myself a good actor, and I can act that way really well. I don't give a shit. I do strange approach a lot. I don't care what people think. I can act that way, but it doesn't work because it just comes across too contrived, and a lot of people don't understand that. Legitimate, a little nervous or like unpredictable energy is really good. In some cases, if you do it in the right amount, it's really, really good for the whole process.
Because it come across as a is natural. You know, yeah. People are not, you know, smooth like that in real life. You know, people naturally, you know, you get shaky. It happened. It's natural. You know, you're not God. It's natural for you to feel, you know, for outside influences to distract you or, you know, anything. You don't want to be too smooth.
Yeah,
you know?
Sometimes I'm talking to girls.
It's not natural. Anyone can pick up on that.
Yeah. That's why sometimes I'm talking to girls, I would even say things like, oh, you know what? I just forgot what I was going to say or I forgot this. You know, and it's okay, you know, because I want to show them. This is one thing people understand, too. One thing people don't understand also, let's say if you're actually coming with the perfect energy and everything, you're going to have to keep that up. Through the whole pickup from meat to sex. Whereas I'd rather the girl accept certain things about me as soon as possible. Like, whether it's a sexual thing, like, I'm going to be sexual, or whether it's like, kind of weird or whatever. Like, I want her to accept that thing about me as soon as possible. Because it makes the future a lot easier. As opposed to, like, you having high standards, trying to create a lot higher standards that don't exist.
Exactly. It's just so
fucking silly. And what the funny thing is that, you know, the writers, I'm sure, like, the writers for Hitch, let's look back at Hitch. I'm sure, like, you were saying, like, the writers, you were saying something about the writers, you said,
know, like, movies like Hitch and all those Hollywood movies, where whatever movie that depict players, they're, you know, one thing people have to understand is that they're written by, you know, writers who are not actually PUAs or people who go out and try to talk to girls. People who actually have, you know, in-field experience. They know what they're doing, you know. They can pick up. They know what works and what doesn't work. These movies are, you know, are being written and produced by people who have no clue what they're doing. They don't know what's real.
Exactly. These movie makers are going after older ideas that have already been established before. Now in real life, it's totally different because people go on one of my blogs and they see, you know, I've been doing a lot of getting a lot of success, and they're wondering, how is this possible sometimes if you don't act exactly like this person, exactly like that person? And what they don't understand is that, you know, what they think is the right way, the ideal way to look and feel when meeting a woman, that came from Hollywood, which came from writers who they themselves, I doubt, had a, you know, that much success doing stranger approaching under that context. So the truth is, and it's my opinion, until a guy has slept with over like 50 or 60 women from pure stranger approaching on the street and day game, he doesn't really, I mean, it's hard for him to really, really know exactly, you know, all the variables that take place that make, you know, stranger day game pickup successful, meaning from meat to sex. Sometimes I had to actually calm down. I mean, I had to actually, you know, purposely come across nervous at some points in certain girls. That way, you know, they can feel like we're on the same level. You know, because if the girl's a little bit nervous and I'm too smooth, it's like too much for her. You know, and vice versa. If she's too comfortable and I'm like too nervous, it's just not gonna work either.
Exactly.
So you want to kind of like be on the same frequency as her, and that's what it's about. You know. And that's why I just wanted to end this whole thing about this ideal thing, this ideal game. You know, and I hate people using movie references as something that's supposed to be done in real life. It's just not.
Yeah, I mean, I bet you if PUAs were the main actors in movie, it would be totally different. You know, people would have a different idea with them. Of what's going on, you know.
Yeah, and that's why I want to end. I want to end this and say this, right? The time is going up. I want to end and say this. At the end of the day, the only thing that really matters is results. Nothing else matters. Doesn't really matter how it looks or how this looks, how that looks, how that person talks, how tall that person is, how short the other person is. All that matters at the end of the day is he getting these girls consistently? And then from there is when you can find the truth. Because remember, our job is not to be right. My job is not to be right. That's too much ego. No. It's to find the truth.
Right.
And I want to urge everybody else who's, you know, who looks at this video and who's studying this game dynamics, especially from the stranger context, even from social developments, social circle stuff, whatever, but we're trying to find the truth here. Like, I'm not going to say I'm the number one authority on this, but we want the truth. We don't want to really you know, just make up things just because they sound good. But let's look at the math. Always look back and break down for yourself, you know. And you know, I know a lot of guys who speak very smooth, who dress very smooth, and they do well with girls in the social situation and social circles. But when you take them out to do stranger approaching, they burn down in flames. They go down. Yes, they go down. That happened. I've seen so much guys do that, and that's why, you know, people think that these naturals or people who are natural, who act, they think that, you know, that they meet girls through strangers. You know, they don't. They mostly meet people in normal situations, or even maybe night stuff where girls are having fun. But day game is a different context, and you know, it has to be respected. You know, and it has to be respected, and you know, that's basically it. And that's how I took my time and developed my domino effect and the flirtation model. That really helped me a lot to you know, meet girls that are more attractive than me. And girls that I probably wouldn't even have been able to get in social circle. Now I can get girls that, you know, 5 years ago I couldn't get them in social circle. Now I can get them from the street, you know, in the hardest way possible. You know, I mean, consistently enough for my like, my taste. And I'm comfortable. And this happens because of me not really looking at the ideal, what's ideal, you know, and stuff like that, and looking for what actually really works. And that's, I think when people focus on that, it's gonna make it a lot more clear to them, as opposed to, you know, you need to let go of ideals. Ideals are okay in the beginning, but you need to let them go and search for the truth, because the truth is what's gonna get you the results, not the ideal. So the Hollywood hit stuff and all that stuff, it's great to look at and stuff like that, but in reality, it's too much. And that's one mistake that a lot of pickup artists in training make. They act so well. They put up a show, a performance, and then guess what? If you imagine, you're on the street and a performer comes to you. They speak loud, clearly, and they demand attention. And then they say, "Hey, we should hang out one day. Give me a number." Let's say you give them a number, like as a bro. All right, cool. Do you really want to hang out with that guy again? I doubt it. No, because you don't connect with them. You're not on the same frequency. So even though the guy's a good actor and he's doing well, he's loud, he's dressed interesting, whatever, it doesn't matter, because it's too much out there. So that's why you have to still understand how to bring, you have to come into their realm and to their frequency and their reality a little bit. You can stand out a little bit, but not too much, and that's what people don't understand. So I hope this helps a lot with the whole ideal gamer, what the ideal gamer is. And from my experiences, I would say, you know, after probably 50 to 60, probably 100 lays from stranger approaching day game, maybe less, I would say probably 50, maybe 40, I think then people kind of would understand a little bit more about what really is, what it's really about, you know. And you know, I think that would just definitely help people. So you know, again, it's good talking to you, and peace out.
Hey, this is radio station WSKEE. We're taking calls on the wish line, making your wacky wishes come true.
Hello? I wish I was a little bit taller. I wish I was a baller. I wish I had a girl who looked good, I would call her. Wish I had a rabbit in a hat with a bat and a 6-4 baller. I wish I was like 6'9", so I could get with Leo. She, 'cause she don't know me, but yo, she's really fine. You know, I see her all the time.